Weekdone is a goal management and weekly reporting platform that helps you set structured goals and keep track of activities. There are two major parts to Weekdone that we'll go over in this video, the quarterly objectives section and the weekly planning section. Using both quarterly objectives and weekly planning together allows you to see how weekly activities help achieve your long-term company goals. When you enter into Weekdone, you'll first get brought to the homepage. This section combines all parts of Weekdone into a single dashboard and gives you an overview of everything important. Now let's open the quarterly objective section. This section lets you manage the long-term goals you're working on. The methodology used within Weekdone is the OKR system. This stands for objectives and key results. Objectives are your large long-term goals, and the key results are the way those goals get accomplished. From here, you can create your own personal objectives. To do this, simply click Add a New Objective. Now you can enter in a goal. For example, we'll add Understand Our Customers and Analyze Their Behavior. Once you enter in an objective, you need to add key results. For this, we'll add the following key results. First, conduct 12 online client surveys and analyze the results. And second, map and analyze all our current marketing channels and give at least 10 recommendations on how to improve them. Key results by default will be set at a percentage of completion, but you can change the weight or type values from the key results settings. Here, we'll change our key result type to surveys and our initial target value to 12. As you work on a key result, use the drag and drop progress bar to track your achievement. You can also comment on your own and other individuals' objectives and key results. This is a great way for giving updates on how the objective is going over time. Now that you've learned how to add an individual OKR, you can do the same at team, department, and company levels, which are accessible from the left sidebar. You can also get the progress reports for any level from the sidebar as well. For now, let's look at the whole company's objectives by clicking Company. On the top of the page, you'll see a visual overview of how your company's OKRs are progressing. The dashboard shows you where you stand towards achieving your objectives and how many of your OKRs are on track, at risk, or off track. At any time, you can create a custom report of the page by selecting the type of report you would like generated from the filter options. You can use the export function to save the created report to PDF or XLS format. We'll now move on to the weekly planning section of Weekdone. Weekly planning helps you and your team keep track of all your weekly activities. First, let's look at your individual weekly report. Here, you can report on your different plans, progress, and problems you had during the week. In the beginning of the week, enter in what plans you'd like to achieve. As you go through the week, you can move your plans into the progress section. Then you can report any problems or issues you had along the way. As you begin using weekly planning, the first step is entering in a plan you'd like to accomplish that week. In this case, we'll add the plan, Finish Design Brief for New Article. When you enter in a new item, you have a few options as to what you can add to it. As you complete a plan, you can simply drag and drop it into the progress section, and it will be reported as completed at the end of the week. You can also click on the item options marked by these three dots. From there, you can mark an item as done, add attachments, select a due date, assign items to a team or individual, or mark an item as private. You can like and comment on both your own and other individuals' items within the company. On your weekly reporting page, if you scroll down, you'll see 5-star questions. These questions are weekly questions assigned by your manager to get insight in how your week is going. You have the ability to access other forms from the side navigation bar. You can simply open up the team or individual form you'd like to view. At the end of the week, all of these items get compiled into a weekly report. To access the weekly report section, go to the side navigation bar and click on the company report. The company report is a compilation of the reports from the rest of your team and the whole company. You can scroll through this to see what everyone is up to. To view another individual or team's form in a quick view, you can simply click on their name and a dropdown will appear. This report will also get sent to you and your team through email, but you can download the report in PDF or XLS format at any time. By default, the form shows the current week, but you have the ability to shuffle through different weeks by either clicking on the arrows or opening up the calendar menu. You can also select different views for the weekly report, such as by users, by categories, by tags, by objectives, and by time. In the top right, you'll find a notification icon. You'll be able to get alerts about posts you've been tagged in and which of your items have been liked or commented on. You can get an overview of all your team's activities in Weekdone from the Newsfeed section. Here, there's a live feed of everyone's activities in Weekdone. This is a quick way to see what's happening from day to day. The last section we'll view is your company and personal settings. To get to your company settings, click the drop-down arrow in the top right, then click on Company. On this page, you can switch on and off different sections in Weekdone, add in people and teams, set permissions, and customize Weekdone exactly to your working process. To change your personal settings and import items from other apps, such as Slack, Jira, and Asana, click the drop-down arrow in the top right and click on Personal. To get comfortable with Weekdone, it's important to explore it on your own. If you need help, we have a variety of articles and videos on our blog and in our FAQ to help you along the way. You can contact us with any questions you have through our support chat or by email.